Now he says, but ye, brethren, are not in darkness that that day should overtake you as a thief. You're the children of light. Now, the rapture of the church actually does two things. It ends this day of grace that we're in, the calling out of the church, a body, a bringing many sons home to glory. That's what God's doing today. Now, the rapture will end that, but it not only ends that, it begins the day of the Lord. The great tribulation will get underway when the church leaves the earth. Now, what is the relationship then? Has the coming of Christ for his church to the day of the Lord? Well, he goes on to say, the times and seasons I don't need, he says, to talk to you about. You know perfectly, he says, the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief. It's taught back in the Old Testament. You know about that. Now, it's coming suddenly, and they think that it's going to be a time of peace, but it's going to be the greatest war the world's ever seen. Now, it's a day of wrath. My, the different ways that it is described. Now, the question is still, how does the coming of Christ for his church, how does that relate to the day of the Lord, which precedes the second coming of Christ? How is that related? The point, I think, is just simply this, that at the translation of the church, the end of the day of grace has come, and now we begin the day of the Lord. And in other words, the one event does two things. It closes one day, it opens another. And that day opens in darkness as the day begins. But we're not in darkness, he says. Now, why aren't we not in darkness? And the day won't overtake us as a thief. Why, we won't be here, friends. We went out, as we found in the last chapter. The Lord himself shall descend from heaven and take his church out of the world. Now, he says, you're children of the light. You don't belong to that dispensation that's coming. You belong to the dispensation of grace that we're in today. And friends, until you learn to make these distinctions in Scripture, you're going to be hopelessly confused. And very candidly, I know of no one so hopelessly confused as some theologians in seminaries today. I've talked to them. One man said he just gave up on prophecy, had nothing to do with it. Why? Well, because he's not willing really to study. And what we have here, when the day of the Lord comes, we're going to be with the Lord. We're not in darkness, he says. Makes that clear. That day should overtake you as a thief, because he's not coming as a thief to the church. We're looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior. Now, he says, therefore, let us not sleep as do others. You see, the blessed hope, that is, the rapture of the church could take place at any time. In view of that, we ought not to be sleeping Christians. I heard a song leader down in Georgia, and in his very quaint way, he uttered a great many wise things. And I wish all song leaders could do that instead of some of them make such asinine statements that are as unbiblical as anything can be. But this boy was right on target. He said, friends, we're going to sing Standing on the Promises. Now, he says there are a lot of folk today that are singing Standing on the Promises, and they're sitting on the premises. Well, and some of them actually are sleeping pillows in the church. Now, what Paul is saying here, in view of the fact that the Lord Jesus is going to take his church out of the world, we won't be here, and the world's going to, those that are not saved are going to enter this awful period. He says, therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. And this business of being sober here, friends, has several meanings. It means not only sober in the sense that you're not using an alcoholic stimulant, but you know, a lot of people get drunk on power, on the making of money, on the pleasures of this world. There are a lot of things that you can get drunk on today and get carried away. You know, there are a lot of people get high today on many things. Now, he says to the child of God, let us be sober and let us watch. Why? Because of these tremendous events that are going to take place in the future. And friends, we may be close to them. I don't know. I think we are, but I don't know that. I believe it with all my heart. And in my judgment, I think the coming of Christ draweth nigh. And I know I can say with Scripture, our redemption is nearer than when we first believed.